Christine Geiger, who is not the woman in the photo next to me right now, is the owner of a Michigan hair salon and has declared that she is refusing service to members of the transgender community. In fact, she posted this and then later deleted it on Facebook, writing, quote, "If a human identifies as anything other than a man or woman, please seek services at a local pet groomer."
Jesus.
"You are not welcome at this salon," period. So I don't know why she's this fired up and angry toward the transgender community, but clearly that's a pretty hateful and terrible thing to write. In her mind, she's just practicing free speech. And I do think that maybe she took the wrong lessons from a recent Supreme Court ruling. We'll get to that in a moment. But you can't just deny service to people because you don't like them and you don't like their identity. In fact, in the state of Michigan, Gretchen Whitmer has signed legislation specifically indicating that businesses cannot discriminate against members of the transgender community. Nonetheless, the post attracted so much negative attention that she eventually deleted it on Facebook and she made the salon's Instagram page private. I'm guessing that there were some negative comments on there in regard to what she had to say. I did find her Instagram page though, which is also set to private, and she's touting her fight against the transgender community. She wrote that she will not cave to BS agendas or the hate that hides behind rainbows and unicorns. Blessed to see the strong ones stepping up and the sheep cowering. Okay, but how does it make you strong to be so offended about the existence of transgender people that you even refuse to provide services for them at your place of business, at your salon? Like, how are they harming you in any way, shape, or form? I don't understand.
Yeah, so this is the problem with the Supreme Court decision where they said, well, creative services are allowed to discriminate and say, hey, my religion or my beliefs say that I should not give you this service. Remember, that case was totally fraudulent in that the lady did not actually have a web design company and she did not have customers asking for her services. They just made it up and the Supreme Court was like, whatever, we just want to rule against these folks and we want to rule in favor of religious fundamentalism. So they took the case and made this decision. And now here we are and she's a hairdresser and she's going, oh, you know what? Now businesses are allowed to discriminate. I want to discriminate. So I just don't like these people.
Right. But okay, so let's talk about the Supreme Court ruling. And you're absolutely right in that, like, the story was made up in order to get this case in front of the Supreme Court justices, right? But there is a distinction, and I feel like that distinction is left out. And for anyone who thinks, oh, this means I could just be a bigot and I can just discriminate against anyone I want. If I don't want to provide services to people because I don't like their identity, I can go ahead and do it. That's not true. So in that ruling, and my understanding is that you can't deny services to a gay couple. However, it is considered compelled speech if you are expected to do something creative that shows support for an ideology that you do not agree with or for an identity you do not agree with.
So that is factual. That is what the ruling says. Now, having said that, think about how vague that is. What's creative and what's not creative?
Yeah, it's true.
Is cutting hair creative? A lot of people could argue that it's creative. Is making a cake creative? A lot of people could argue that. But then once you start arguing that, oh, you go, you know what? You said baking a cake was creative, potentially, right? Well, so is cooking food then, by definition. And so now these people have come into my restaurant and I don't like them. Now here we are back in the civil rights days. Now that was based on race, so I don't like these black people coming into my restaurant. I got a creative service called cooking. And so that's it, they're banned from my restaurant. Now I'm not sure they could do it on race here, but they could definitely do it on religion. Okay, and they could definitely use their religion and weaponize it against different groups, including the trans community and other parts of the LGBTQ community. And they could say, my religion says to hate you. And hey, I was so creative with that apple pie I made, so now you're banned from my restaurant. And now when anybody walks into a restaurant or any other business, a hairdresser, etc., they're like, okay, what are you? Oh, you're trans, you're banned. No, that's a sick policy, and that is un-American. And we've got a big problem on our hands because this is the beginning. This is nowhere near the end. tons and tons of right wingers are gonna start banning people in that community.
Yeah, and I mean, she seems pretty, I mean, even though she has set her accounts to private, she seems pretty defiant and continues to say, like, she really feels like she's fighting something evil here, right?
Yeah.
When in reality, these are people, like, look, I would venture to say that if you have this kind of hatred toward any group, people in that group aren't gonna want your services anyway. But she feels like she's some sort of warrior against a dangerous group of people, when in reality, we're just talking about normal people who are part of the transgender community. Now, if there was something specific done to her, then that's one thing, but nothing has been done to her. You get what I'm saying? She's just thinking about potential customers coming in looking for services and having the ability to just straight up tell them, I don't like you, I don't like what you stand for, and so I don't wanna provide a haircut or color or anything for you.
So Anna, this is where, I don't know if you and I disagree, but look, so you didn't grow up fundamentalist and I didn't grow up fundamentalist, and I think that we have trouble understanding the fundamentalist mind. And so that's why I'm a little bit harsher to them than I think you are. Because for fundamentalists, they think hatred is okay. They think it's moral. They think the moral thing to do is pick a group of people, and in the past it used to be based on race, but now we move to different categories, and now we're in this category, and they think the moral thing, the thing that God wants me to do to be a decent person, is to hate this person.
I get you. Yeah, no, but like, okay, look, I don't know if she's fundamentalist. Do you know if she's fundamentalist?
Well, because anybody who says this.
There are plenty of people in the country who are not fundamentalists, and they have hate in their hearts toward the transgender community. And what I'm trying to understand is, when we're just talking about people who are living their lives and they have absolutely no impact on your life at all, why hate them? Why have that kind of existence?
Well, so that brings us to the same issue, because at some point that hate has to enter your head, right? So, because you're not born with it, everybody's born basically with a blank slate and they get taught by their parents, media, and all these different factors that affect you, right? So, fundamentalist religion does propaganda, and of all the religions, don't pick on any of the religions, okay? But they, almost all of them, do propaganda against the LGBTQ community. That's the one thing, unfortunately, they're united on. Remember, not all religious people, fundamentalist religious people, united in their hatred of gays. So they tell people, whenever they go to church, mosque, whatever it is, the gay people, bad, 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 bad. Now trans people, bad, 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 bad. And it gets in their head, oh, the moral thing to do is to hate them. Or it could be propaganda from a non-religious organization like Fox News. So you turn into Fox News or Matt Walsh or whoever those guys, and they're like, the moral thing to do is hate, 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 and it gets into their heads.
No, that's absolutely true.
And they become fundamentalists politically, right? Yeah. And so that's why you're getting this. So, you know, I mean, there is no justifiable reason at all. The reason to bring up the fact that she's not personally affected, it's not like, anyway, I don't even want to get into examples of how they could possibly be personally affected. But it's a hatred born out of not facts, but propaganda that got into their heads.
And fear, and fear. So after she had deleted that Facebook post, it's not like she changed her mind or anything. In fact, she doubled down on a different Facebook page. So Geiger doubled down in a post on Sunday, July 9th on the Overheard in Traverse City Facebook group. She said she has no issue with lesbian, gay, or bisexual customers, but said she will not support the TQ plus community, meaning the transgender, queer, and you know, the plus represents other genders, other sexualities and stuff. Like, but why the distinction? Like, why do you feel that transgender or queer individuals pose some sort of risk or threat to you at all? Like, anyway, I'm trying to figure it out, but obviously this is not something that we can answer here. Like, we don't know.
I can figure it out. In that case, she's leaning, it sounds like she's a political fundamentalist rather than a religious fundamentalist, because for the religious fundamentalists, a man shall not lie with a man, and they're done with it, right? So they're not gonna make that distinction as much. But for political fundamentalists, they've been taught by Fox News, guys, it's bad politics to be against gays, lesbians, and bisexual people. There's too many of them, and they're in our families too. They're in conservative families.
But so are transgender people.
I know, but there's not enough of them. So that's why, remember, the right wing, guys, when they went to go target the transgender community, did they just pick it out of a hat? No, they just they go down a ladder of hatred. In the beginning, it started with black people. Oh, black people suck. Oh, they're terrible. Oh, we shouldn't give them rights. And it was called the Southern Strategy. The Republican Party actively chose to be racist in that regard. That stopped working after a while because people were like, it's getting pretty ugly. And so that was the genius of the Civil Rights Strategy, mm-hmm. et cetera, Martin Luther King, beyond brilliant. That got them away from that. In some degree, they made it more subtle. Fast forward, and in 2004, they go, okay, this racism against black people, Latinos is not working as well. Trump brought it back later. But in 2004, they're like, okay, let's do ballot measures against gay marriage, because now we could discriminate against gay people, and that could still drive hatred. Because our base, their thinking is, we drive more people to the voting booth by getting them really angry, right? And really fearful, to your earlier point.
True.
So then, being against gay people stopped working, and around 2013, that's why Biden and Obama all of a sudden were like, oh yeah, gay marriage, yeah. They found the political courage once the number got to about over 50% of the country, near 60% saying yes, we're in favor of gay marriage. Now, they tried this with trans rights, and actually, that didn't work in the beginning. You remember how they tried to ban them from the military? Trump tried to do that, and that was kind of a disaster. It didn't help them in the polling. They tried it with bathrooms, mm-hmm. tried to ban them. That didn't help either. But they dug and dug and dug, and they got to the thing about sports, etc.
And
that did work. And over 70% of the country says, no, we don't like that. So then they use that to go, trans people bad, until a hairdresser in Michigan, for no reason, is like, oh, I heard they were bad and evil, and they're corrupting the kids, and whatever excuse Fox News was using. So now I'm banning them from my.
Yeah.
And she further
writes, by the way, she further wrote, this stance was taken to ensure that clients have the best experience. And I am admitting that since I am not willing to play the pronoun game or cater to requests outside of what I perceive as normal. But like, oh, all right. So, I mean, imagine being so offended by having to use pronouns that a person would like you to use to respect them, that you, again, hurt your business. Because now, look, now she's getting harassed, okay? Now people are boycotting her salon. And on top of that, some of the, there's professional fallout. So hair care company Jack Wynn has pulled products from the salon. I'm sure others will follow. It's just stupid. When you're that controlled by your fear and hatred toward a group of people, you end up hurting yourself more than anything. And I wish that she understood that.
Yeah, and lastly on the pronouns. So this woman says, I don't wanna play the pronoun game. Now, if somebody in any part of our community walked in and said, I demand that you change your pronouns. And I know we've gotten tons of hate for this, but we would be on her side and say, no, don't mess with her pronouns or whatever she wants to call herself. But what I never understand about right-wingers is, why do they care about your pronouns? Like, what business is it of yours? So somebody walks in and says, hey, hey, can you call me he? For whatever reason, I don't even care. Why would I care, right? Yeah. And she's like, no, I hate your pronouns. I don't want to play the pronoun game. Why? Because it bothers you so much to be a decent human being and just call them what they asked to be called. What they asked to be called.
Simple. It's the easiest thing. Anyway.
Yeah. We think it's the easiest thing in the world. You want to be called that? Great. You get called that. You want to be called that? Great. You get called that. But for right wingers, and now some on the left, but mainly 98% right wingers, like, no, I will not respect what you want to be called. Okay. But that's weird, and it makes you the bad guy. Thanks for watching The Young Turks, really appreciate it. Another way to show support is through YouTube memberships. You'll get to interact with us more. There's live chat, emojis, badges. You've got emojis of me, Anna, John, JR. So those are super fun. But you also get playback of our exclusive member only shows and specials right after they air. So all of that, all you gotta do is click that join button right underneath the video. Thank you.